But right about now we have Mr. Errol Bean, they call him what?
Original Mr. Bean.
Mr. Bean, looking rather dapper.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? And of course we have him here with us. He is a writer.
He's song, a singer. Everything.
I mean, you're just so versatile. You have so many things going for you, you know?
Thank you.
I think we shouldn't even ask him what he does. We should ask him what does he not do.
What don't you do, right?
I don't fight.
You don't fight.
No. Fair enough. All right. Well, welcome to CTV Live.
Thank you very much.
Now, you just launched a new album called Beyond the Rhythm. I'm really taken in with it, the name.
Yes.
Beyond the Rhythm. Tell us about the why you chose that name, first of all.
Simply put, Beyond the Rhythm means that I like my listeners to get behind the music, mm-hmm. and when the words are finished, when the rhythm is finished, mm-hmm. the words and the meaning must linger. Meditation, we're talking about introspection, reflection, taking you beyond the rhythm.
Isn't that kind of difficult, especially with the Jamaican culture where we're so rhythm oriented and rhythm driven?
No, because I don't mean that the rhythm is not important. In fact, I want the rhythm to be the driving force behind it. That's why we have real live instruments on the album. Uh-huh. So the rhythm is part of it. But what we want is that people do not just get caught up with the rhythm, but they find that there is substance beyond the music and the words.
Okay.
In introspection.
Right. So we've seen a bit of the launch right about now. We just saw some excerpt from the launch.
Okay.
And we saw you there really enjoying yourself.
It was a nice occasion. Right? I really enjoyed myself.
Tell us a bit about it.
Well, it was put together by great Jackie Tyson from Thought to Finish and Carla Ribbon Stewart or Stewart Ribbon, whichever. And my friend Carla, take it easy. And she's from Ultimate Events. And we had several noted artists like Ken Bode, Abijah, we had Dwight Pinkney, the DP band, and
these artists have done collaborations
with some of my co-producers, and mm-hmm. we had Nambo Robinson and
serious
Gibby.
Yes,
the album is really represented some of the top musicians in Jamaica, including mm-hmm. Ernie Ranglin and Wayne Arman is in there too, Dennis Rushton, John Williams.
You went for the best, the cream of the crop.
Yes, Pam Hall, Noella Eldridge.
Harmonizing.
Yes, yeah. Sabrina Williams. And as I said, I did some combination with some of the top artists in Jamaica. Mm-hmm.
That's a very strong, powerful lineup.
Absolutely, yes. So how well did the launch go and how is the album doing now?
The launch went on extremely well. People are saying that is the best album launch they have seen in Jamaica.
What?
And people are saying, this is the ultimate album. I am trying not to brag here because we're not into the pride thing, but I must pick up this album. Yes. I mean, I've said to people, I am the least on the album. So I'm talking about the caliber of musicians and singers that have combined to give me this. And I cannot forget my producer, my producer, engineer, Rowan Dwyer, the greatest engineer in the whole world.
What is so special about him?
Rowan is good.
I know you know he's good.
Rowan is not only motivating to me, but his technical skills far beyond what some people realize. But he is big, but he's a very humble fellow. He's very tall. but he's humble and he's good at mixing and mastering and big up Rowan Dwyer, wherever I am, brother.
You mentioned you weren't bragging, but you had a review in the Gleaner.
Yeah.
Yes, and the great Mel Cook bigged up the
Mel
the
Cook
review,
every time, man.
And he was very precise, and I give thanks to him mm-hmm. for the way he put it. Big up to the Gleaner and Mel Cook.
So you possibly say you're having the best time of your life now.
Well, the best is yet to come. That is my motto. The best is always yet to come. But I am now living a dream which I had when I was a little boy.
Oh, so you've always wanted to do
Yes, this. That was my only dream, to be a singer-songwriter. But my life went around several corners. And I actually started recording in 1987. I did Freedom, a remake, the second track on the album. I'm not going to tell you who I sang that song with because I'm thinking of the question. Okay. I did Love Your Woman, a song appealing to men to love their women and mind them pick and take care of them.
That song is
going to be re-recorded for the next album that Rowan is going to do for me. He's my producer for now. And the fact is this, we had started, but the hurricane came, not the one present one, the first big hurricane that we got in our time, in our year, Gilbert, it stopped me. And so I just decided that, look, my beard is getting gray. People may not want to see me performing again. So before it gets too bad, you people want to talk to me, let me do this. So I got around and did it.
All right, we're talking about the album. We'd like the viewers to have a look at it, if we can get a close-up.
Beyond the Rhythm.
Beyond the Rhythm. Mm-hmm. You want to hold your own album and show
Thank
it
you,
to
I'm proud to do that. That's
this is right.
Album.
And you know, I have to say, you know, Mr. B, he's something else. Something he's the ultimate promoter. You believe in what you're doing,
yes,
and you absolutely promote it
yes.
to the best of your ability.
It is good. I think every Jamaican and every person in the world should have this album. Because it's not just about money.
Especially with the holidays coming up
yes,
now,
Yes, no, and I should say this. This album is dedicated in part to the children at Dare to Care Children's Home.
Absolutely.
25% of yes. what I've sold since and at the launch will be given. And I have mm-hmm. budgeted it already. I'm giving 25% and I will do this. I'm not saying I will give them 25% of the 300 million that I'm going to make from this album. But I will
Lord.
Do so. And, so it's not about the money, but I'm on a mission for God.
And we might add here that Dare to Care is a part of Mustard Seed.
Yes,
and of course, Dare to Care, they take care of children with HIV yes. AIDS. So it's really a worthy
yes.
cause.
Yes, and also on this album, is the great Norma Brown Bell and Rosamond Brown reading the poem on a rhythm created by the great Dennis Rushton called Dare to Care. And that poem was featured, is featured on the album. And you should get this, everybody. You need to have Rosamond Brown voice, not on radio, but on a CD, Norma yes. Brown Bell, and all the other great persons that are on it.
Yeah, you have a right to boast.
Thank you very much.
You say you don't want to show up, but that is a wonderful record.
Yeah, it's a good package, really a good package.
People think that this is the ultimate album. And I intend to do more, but if I never did another album, I could go home safely. And I've left something.
And that's why you're willing to even give this away
yes,
this evening.
Yes, we're
a whole package here, yes, album and two books. Because Mr. Bean is also an author. Yes, he writes, you have one, A Flower Blooms.
Yes, that's my first publication, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So we've been talking about the album. Could yes. we talk a little bit more about your books?
Okay.
This is one of them that I'm looking at.
This book was published in 1989. Mm-hmm. And I did it, I was motivated to do this to help the Women's Crisis Center. And I launched this book, and they got some money out of it. And I put on a show after that, motivated by this book, with Cynthia Sloss. And 15 days or so after, she was very nice to me at the Pegasus Hotel. She didn't charge me much, she just charged taxi fare. She died, and I said, okay, I have to do something
tribute.
For Cynthia. And I wrote this book in less than a year. Collaborated with several of Jamaican top artists, like Beris Ammon, name them, Ernest Smith, everybody, Norma Brown Bell is in there too. Norma Brown Bell is my good friend. Everybody, all the world never know. Norma Brown Bell is my good friend.
Seems
she
that
works
way.
With me every time, yes. And so this book is dedicated to Cynthia Sloss. Not a profit-making book. I've given most of this to the musicians, anybody I come across in music, in radio, in communication, I give one to them. And if you haven't
That's
gotten
true.
You got
have
one.
Gotten one.
Yes,
I
didn't get any.
I
you will get one before I leave here. I don't have
I
enough
have
to give
a copy
everybody
of both.
Tonight. Yes. Yeah, but so we are into giving and we are into promoting goodness and positive living because we are on a God thing.
It's not all about the money.
No, I mean, I want to make money because if I don't make money, I can't do other works and give to charity.
Absolutely.
But I'm into this God business of liberating humankind and women. And Saturday we will appear at the Women's Conference to sing one of my big songs called My Mama. So
Women's Conference, right?
Yes.
And of course,
Dundin Ferguson is behind it, and my good friend too.
Okay, so you'll be doing that.
Yes, I'll be doing that one of the songs, and one
Powerful.
Of the combination. Yeah,
great.
Yes, yes.
And also,
hearing.
I should say that Saturday evening, I was gonna say this, but let me say this after because you're gonna ask a question, which I shouldn't say.
So maybe
the question
this is the time
is
you,
yes.
the question.
You can call 967.
4497.
And the question is, who is the artist that does a collaboration
on the song?
On the song Freedom.
Freedom. Freedom. Freedom.
Mm-hmm.
That's
and then can
song.
You imagine you'll win not just the album alone.
Two books.
But you win the two books.
And so release on me a poem, Dare to Care.
It's a package.
Yes,
it's a package
you'll have
deal.
This also, this is what, the poem?
No, the poem is on the
okay,
bookmark.
Okay, on the bookmarker.
Yes.
You wrote this?
Yes,
Can
I
Can you
I
read this for us?
I'm not very good at reading. I would prefer to ask Norma Brown Bell to read for me,
okay.
but she's not here tonight. Let me see if I could read like Rosamond Brown did it. It says, Dare to Care. If you can dare to care and give others hope to live, if you can dare to care and to the needy freely give, if you can dare to care and your blessings gladly share, If you can dare to care and stretch a helping, healing hand. If you can dare to care and count not the price and the sacrifice. If you can dare to care and crave not a reward in paradise, you may send rays of sunshine in the dark, the faint-hearted to inspire. You may light a torch of love that shall be extinguished, be quenched never.
Mm. Yeah, man.
No. I wrote this for Dare to Care of the Mustard Seeds community.
But I didn't get one of those. I need
well,
to get one.
I have
wonderful.
So many things that you haven't got.
So many
I have so many poems. I have so many pieces to
I
put together.
No,
just
that,
recently,
that's an excellent
one. Yeah, just recently, the Atlantic Review out of Long Island reviewed some of my works, and I'm going to get a few copies. I will, mm-hmm. and I promise you one, but I will see to that. You'll be aware of it. But we are doing a lot of stuff, and anyway, that's freedom in the background there.
Yes.
But
9674497. You can call in and give us the name of the artist who performed the song "Freedom" with Mr. Errol Bean. Okay.
Because we don't want to have to walk away with these books.
Right. At the end of the day, you know, so you can give us a call. But you know, you're also motivated. You're, you know, full of motivation.
Yes.
You have a mission.
Yes.
What? Because you said as a boy, you always wanted to do this.
Yes.
Right? As you went along and you didn't really do it right away, what kept you inspired? What kept you motivated to really to continue
well,
on the road?
One of the things I like my audience to know tonight is that I'm also an ordained minister of religion.
Okay.
And I'm a trained teacher, university.
I've
sold life insurance everything. Successfully. I've been to the $1 million round table top.
All right.
And so what has kept me is a sense that I was born for a special purpose.
Absolutely.
And I thought it was going to be achieved through the church, quote unquote, the physical church. I'm still in the church. I don't work in the church anymore. I'm not bashing the church. I'm a Christian. I will always be. I cannot not be a Christian. But the fact is that I was thrown out of the church because of my theological posturings and the people not fully understanding that the Holy Spirit could work through a normal human being the way it did.
Give us an example of that. You said you were thrown out of the church.
Yeah, I was fired from the church. I'm going to say this. Anywhere I go, I will say it, and I'm not bashing the church because that's my history. We had a very great spiritual experience in the church, and eventually I was fired from the local church, not from the higher body, but I was fired, and so I have been looking for my mission since 1981, and I have kept the pace. I've kept writing, meditating, doing stuff to keep my spirit strong. And when I realized that I had become 50, and I'm 53 now, in February gone, and I said, if I died now, what would I leave?
What is a legacy?
What a question.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I said, each man should decide, and woman should know how he or she will want to exist, mm-hmm. to exit, rather. When I went to Wayne Armand to do a couple of tracks, I said, Wayne, I am going to do this album because this is how I want to live. But I've changed my mind since. I want to do at least 3 albums for you.
So you're not ready to go yet?
No.
Okay.
I mean, there's much more to accomplish.
Okay.
But my mind's on the question, what has kept me, the view that I was born for a special purpose.
Definitely.
And this purpose is being fulfilled in this album.
Mm-hmm. Mr.
Bean, it's not just about money.
We have someone who
we
wants
have a
the
caller.
CD. We have a caller.
Really?
The package.
Good evening. Welcome to CTV Live.
Good evening.
How are you doing? Where are you calling from?
Almanton.
All right.
Can you answer the question or do you have a question for Mr. Bean?
Yes, the answer is Abuja.
All right. Come on.
Congratulations.
Freedom, you've won the CD and 2 books. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And thanks for calling.
Yeah, you
just
too.
Hold the line.
Hold the line,
please. If you find me at CWJ Credit Union in the week, I'll autograph the album for you.
Okay.
And as you mentioned, Abijah and myself will be performing this song at Emancipation Park on Saturday about 5:30. The show is on from 1 o'clock, but he'll be on about 5, and we'll be busting this song out there.
Hey, bust it.
It was great to have you.
Thank
respect.
You so
Thanks
much.
For coming.
Yes. Keep up the good work.